What up? This is your man, DJ TJ. This is Friday Night Live. You are listening to WKTJ Reverence Radio. It is November the 6th, 2020. And this is your welcome for the week. If this is your first time here, we give you the welcome. We come back and give you our sponsor. We give you the news. We come back and give you the new songs of the week. And then we clean up what we messed up. And we find out what we missed during the news, and we have a very, very wonderful weekend, God willing. And that's basically the entire podcast. So, if you're my day one, you know I love you and I miss you, and I thank you for returning once again, and thank you for being here for me and supporting the podcast. If this is your first time here, we hope you will return after you hear the news and how we do things. We give you nothing but the best in gospel music, funk, and jazz. There's many things to come. We have a long list of things for the news to talk about today. So sit right there. Don't move a muscle. We will be right . Hey, how you doing? If you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. Let me explain. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or your computer. And Anchor will distribute your podcast for you so you can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can also make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast, all in one place. Download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started. Right now. I did.
This DJ's in the mix. Thank you.
Here is the latest news from your favorite gospel station.
We're back. This is your man, DJ TJ. This is Friday Night Live. You're listening to WKTJ Rebels Radio. It is November 6th, 2020. And this is what is in your news. Joe Biden has had a pretty impressive last couple of days and even election night, making his way through a lot of different states, gathering their states and their electoral votes, college votes. And he is currently in the lead in position to become president as we speak. Now, when you listen to this, he might have already won the presidential election. But as of right now, while I'm recording this, he has almost made his way to winning. He's just shy of 270. And on the other side of the race is Donald Trump, trying to come up with different ways to ruin the chances of a celebration for Joe Biden and Kamala Harris becoming president and vice president of the United States by way of legal action. And almost every state that he cannot lead in, Biden is in the lead in four different key battleground states where they are really close and it's too close to call the race in that state. And Trump is leading in two of those states, and there's six altogether. But the main states that people are looking at is Pennsylvania, Nevada, and Arizona. Now, Georgia is very, very close as well, but there will be a recount in Georgia because of how close it is. There will also be a recount in Wisconsin because it is presumed that Joe Biden had won that state. They did not project him to be a projected winner of that state. They said he is the presumed or pronounced winner of that state. And there's a lot of legal action going on now. Recently, judges have cleared up some of the lawsuits and some of the issues that Donald Trump has had with these certain states. And he still has an issue. One state said, okay, we will make sure that each of the party's representatives has at least 6 feet away from the view of those who are counting the ballots. Because Donald Trump said they weren't allowed to see what was going on with the ballots. And in other states, he's saying that there are ballots that are being counted late, and they are being counted when they're not supposed to be, as in illegal votes or ballots. When in reality, all the ballots have not been even counted even as of Tuesday, which was election day. And some states weren't even allowed to begin counting the ballots until today. So his gripe and his argument toward a lot of different states and his problem with a lot of what's going on with Joe Biden being the lead or winning is irrelevant and not valid. And he has made many statements that are really making people upset in his own campaign and in his GOP party. So, it is expected that Joe Biden and Kamala Harris will present herself on prime time tonight around 9 o'clock. Arizona or another state is supposed to announce more ballots, and that is supposed to put him most likely over the top. And if not, then he will continue to say what he has said since Tuesday. We're going to count all the ballots, and until every ballot is counted, we are not announcing victory. Unlike Donald Trump, who has announced victory and said that if all the legal ballots are counted, he's going to easily win. And if all the illegal votes and stuff are counted, then they will try to steal the election, which is not something you say, for one. For two, has no merit behind it for him to say that, because all the votes that are being counted right now are all legal votes. And if he loses, he will lose fair and square. So this is just one of those attempts to say, if I don't win, there's a problem. And that's something we used to do as kids, you know what I'm saying? So he has an issue. He's had an issue since he's been in his presidential race run, when he lost to somebody else and he wanted to say there was a problem, there was cheating going on when he lost. And he came out before the election started voting, the votes being counted. He said it's hard for him to lose. It's not easy for him to lose. It's not easy for anybody to lose. I just want to say that. And we're going to move on. But Joe Biden is going to be your next president of the United States. It's just not yet. It's when all the votes are all said and done, Joe Biden will win. And that's me saying that, because it's no way that he cannot be your next president. It's just not going to not happen. So that's who won the race, y'all. You were wondering, and you're not keeping up with politics or anything, you don't watch the news, Joe Biden is going to be your next president of the United States, and will be inaugurated on January 20th, 2021. And as far as for the Senate and the House remains Democratic, but the majority is not there. The House was moved around. There are some Republican seats that have been taken over from Democrats in the House, but the majority still remains Democratic. The Senate, there will be runoffs in the Senate, and they have to wait for another election, which is, that's what the runoffs are, another election, to see who wins those races, because they were so tight and close. And as of right now, if the Democrats win those runoffs, they will get the majority of the Senate as well as the House, and then Joe Biden will also be president, and we will have the blue wave that's been talked about for a very long time. So that is that. Okay? So there's a lot of protesters and everything going on in Nevada and in Arizona and in Georgia. And currently, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris are in Delaware. And that's where they will announce or speak tonight in front of everyone. All right? Paul Shanley is a priest at Center of Sex Scandal. He is now dead at the age of 89. He was a convicted pedophile, former mass priest, and he was in Massachusetts with the sex abuse scandal. Years after ministering to alienated youth in the 1960s and 70s, dozens of men came forward and said Shanley had molested or raped them. He was 89 years old. Mitt Romney scolds Trump for damaging democracy by making claims the election was stolen. Well, he made a lot of different statements that said that the whole system was a fraud. And he is claiming that there's a lot of fraud, voter fraud going on in a lot of different states, just like in Pennsylvania, in Georgia, and Arizona and Nevada. So Mitt Romney doesn't like that. He's scolding Trump for that remark. Says he's reckless. Even Stephen Colbert gave an emotional late night monologue over Trump's election lies. He briefly broke down and said Trump's baseless claims are fraud, cast a dark shadow over the country. Called him a fascist. He told the Republicans they need to choose Donald Trump or the American people. A lot of people are really under his spell, which is really sad. They don't understand why people are upset with him and do not like him. They're just listening to everything he says. There's a lot of people who do not care if he lost. They're going to believe any and everything that he says. So this is just crazy to me. I don't get it. A lot of people need to decide whether they, you know, are on the right side of their mind to the law. Aspirin, seen as potential virus treatment after hospitalized COVID-19 patients, take a daily dose. The patients had lower risk of complications and death compared to those who are not taking it. All right, aspirin. All right, I don't know who this guy is. His name is Davon Daquan Bennett. Known professionally as King Von, was an American rapper from Chicago, Illinois. He was signed to Little Durk's record label. The rising Chicago rapper was outside Atlanta club Friday morning and was shot. He was dead at 26. I have no idea who that is. Philadelphia. Police investigate bomb threat against vote counting center. There was a man who was arrested. Young man, I think he was 20 years old, arrested outside the center with guns. Outside the voting center. And it has been said that you should not take the results of these races for an answer. There was someone on the news or television screen in Philadelphia saying, demand a recount or demand they stop the count. And there's just been a lot of unrest. So, Philadelphia police investigated a bomb threat made against the city's convention center. and the police evacuated the area. No devices were found. All right. The GOP is now calling on the Supreme Court to step in. Justice Alito temporarily grants Pennsylvania GOP request to enforce segregation of late ballots. So they're going to separate the late ballots and find out if they're legal or not. Biden will deliver a primetime address with victory in sight. So prepare for that. Don't know what time it's going to be, but and the infection rate has skyrocketed over 100,000 daily. Cases. Al Roker has prostate cancer. Oh, man, this is crazy. That's all for tonight, you all. It short tonight. I will go through all that news, but it's just the same old, same old. The most important thing to know is that Joe Biden will be president very, very soon. Very, very, very soon. And, the economy added 638,000 jobs in October, and unemployment has sunken to 6.9% in a strong show for economy. Not to mention, because of everything that's going on with the election, the Wall Street has had nothing but green advances. Packers beat the 49ers last night in Thursday night football. And just remember that we do have a web page. Shout out to all those on YouTube. Make sure you hit that bell icon to know when we will be posting another video. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. If this is a great video for you, hit that like button so YouTube will share this video. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And make sure you share as well. Get your merchandise on our webpage, www.wixsite.com. Sorry, www.wkt.wixsite.com/radio page. That's my fault. I'm distracted right now. Make sure you go to the third page, and on the third page is our store page where you can get your merchandise. And Support the cause, you all. All right, we'll be right back with the song of the week. This is your man, DJ TJ. This is WKTJ Reverence Radio. This is Friday Night Live. It is November the 6th, 2020. We'll be right back.
Who's that spinning on the ones and twos? It's your favorite gospel DJ.
You still love me in spite of me. You still chose me. How can it be? Every scar, every flaw, you see it all. You see it all. You still love me. In spite of me, in spite of me, I don't cross every T, I don't dot every I. Got more flaws than a little, and I messed up a thousand times. I don't always commit. Sometimes I give up way too quick, and then I get tired of trying to run away from who I am to who I wanna be. Some days are better than others. I can be up and I'm down, but beyond my mistakes, found in your grace, and this one thing will never change. You still love me in spite of me. Woo! You still chose me. How can it be? Every scar, every flaw, you see it all. You see it all. You still love me. Love me. Oh, in spite of me. I'm stubborn at heart, quick to put up a guard. Do it all by myself, I won't ask for help. But sometimes my mouth is smart, I can be insecure. Counting other people's blessings, I never stop to notice what I got. Some days are better than others, I can be up and I'm down. Beyond my mistakes, I'm found in your grace. And this one thing will never change.
You still love me. Woo!
In spite of me. You still chose me.
You still chose me.
How can it be?
How can it be?
Every scar.
Every scar.
Every flaw. You see it all. You see it all. You still love me. Say yeah. Yeah, can I get a witness? Yeah. You didn't give me what I deserve.
Yeah.
Love so relentless, and yeah. I'm singing hallelujah.
Yeah.
Oh, can I get a witness?
Yeah.
You didn't give me what I deserve.
Yeah.
Love so relentless.
Yeah.
I've been singing, you still love me. In spite of me, you still chose me. How can it be?
How can it be?
Every scar,
every scar,
every flaw,
you see it all.
You see it all. You still love me, love me, oh, in spite of me. It's hard to believe. Have a choice, and daily you choose me. It's hard to believe you have a choice.
You have a choice.
Oh, and daily,
daily.
You choose me.
You choose me.
It's hard to believe.
It's hard to believe.
You have a choice.
You have a choice.
God and daily.
And daily.
You still choose
you
me.
Choose.
Say it's hard.
It's hard to believe.
Oh, you have a choice.
You have a choice.
We're back. We enjoyed that song. That's the new song of the week. That was Tasha Cobbs, Leonard, with In Spite of Me. This is your man, DJ TJ. This is Friday Night Live. You are listening on WKTJ Reverence Radio. It is November 6th, 2020. And only thing I missed on the news today was that, surprise, surprise, football is back. And there was a conference that was left out of starting the season, which is the Pac-12. They are going to be back tomorrow morning. So prepare yourself for that. Okay? Other than that, make sure you take care of yourself If you don't have a church home, get yourself a church home. If you don't have a Bible, get yourself a Bible. And remind yourself that you can always get merchandise from WKTJ Reverence Radio. And a friendly reminder, we are moving. As soon as the building owner comes back from self-isolation, we will be moving into a new building. So prepare yourself for that, you all. Going to be on the FM dial somewhere, as well as here. I'll make sure the two are intertwined. So we are gaining listeners instead of losing you all. We're gaining a whole another group of listeners here in the States as far as our antenna will go. And taking into consideration, if you were looking for stimulus checks, that we have to wait and wait and wait some more, because we have a new president coming and there will be new House of Representatives in the House. There will be new senators in the Senate. They have to be sworn in before they can get to work. And because of that, we have to wait on another bill. Now, Nancy Pelosi is not trying to wait. And Mitch McConnell won his race and is looking forward to a new stimulus package. But we still have the same president. This is what's called the lame duck session in between elections and in between presidents, in between whatever you want to call it. We're in between the next inauguration. We're in between the next swearing in of senators and House representatives. We're in between. That's a lame duck season or session. So during this lame duck session, there's not much that this particular present Congress plans on getting done, because for one, their president is fighting this election, and for two, most of them didn't want another package anyway. So keep that in mind. I am almost out of here, you all. But we are this close to a big change coming for your boy. So keep me in your prayer, if you decide to ever pray for me. Keep me in your prayers. Remember, we have house, I should say, hour of power every Thursday at 7 at Mind, Body, and Soul Ministries in here in Lansing, Michigan. Don't forget, and that's all we're going to do today, you all. I hope you have a very, very wonderful weekend. Make sure you take care of yourself. Wear your mask. Protect yourself and protect others. Make sure you take care of yourself. It's your man, DJ TJ. This is Friday Night Live. Listening on WKTJ Reverence Radio.
It's time to get your praise on with the number one gospel station.
Gospel station.
Gospel station.
Lord, we're so grateful, and we want to offer you this praise.
You've done so much that I am grateful for. Thank you, Lord. My heart's so full, but I can't tell it all. Thank you, Lord, that you've been good. Yes, you have, Lord, more than I can say.
Purpose, help me say it. Let's go.
You've done so much that I am grateful for. I'll just say, that's what I'll say. My heart's so full, but I can't tell it all. I'll just say, cause you've been good. Hey, you've been good, Lord, more than I can say. You want to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All I have is thank you, Jesus. It's not enough, but that's all I've got. All I have is thank you, Jesus. That's all. That's all I've got. Help me say, y'all sound mighty good to me. Yeah, but that's all I've got. Sing it again, y'all. Hey, yeah, that's all I've got. Take it all I've got. Say it again. You've been good on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, all week long. That's all I've got, Lord. Come on. Somebody is grateful. You ought to tell them thank you. That's all. We're so grateful. You didn't have to be so good. But you've been good, Jesus, and we're grateful. You've been good. Somebody ought to testify and say it. More than I can say. Every survivor of this season, you ought to say it. If you survive COVID, you ought to say it. What you're going to say? Thank you. Your testimony ought to be so good. I can't tell it all. Come on, purpose, say it again. Let's get it in the house. Say it like you really mean it. I need y'all to sing along with us. Every survivor, every worshiper, lift your voice and sing. You've been so good. Thank you,
Father's arms are open. bow down before
Him,
for He is
Lord.
Altar.